Okay, guys, so I'm on 2056 Arizona's front area, and the block's, you know, not gorgeous, but there's a lot of new construction going on around Arizona, so you can see that the house looks pretty nice. It's got a hardy panel front, two-story, very contemporary. And I'm gonna now walk inside. So you enter in through a small living room space, but you know, decent enough, but it goes right from the front door into the living room. It has a center kitchen, very contemporary, bamboo floors throughout, open stairs that lead up to the second floor, and it looks like closed stairs, but an open wall that goes down into the basement. So here's the kitchen, beautiful kitchen, very nice. Looks like it's totally knocked out. It's located more in the center, and then you have a little pantry above the refrigerator, and then you have your dining area and a nice yard, as you can see outside. It's kind of a nice yard, it's all gravel. So here's the kitchen sink. So you get your perspective here. Here's the cabinets. And there's that little dining space. And then here you have a coat closet or pantry right next to that refrigerator. And I'm turning around. I hope you're not getting seasick, sorry. There you go, open stairs. And then we're walking down to the basement, which looks like it's finished and it has a closed door. There you go. Not finished, but at least it's closed off. The basement has sort of like a damp kind of smell to it, but it doesn't look like it's wet as far as I can see. Everything is completely new. It has central air. Looks like the PVC valve is there. We see some insulation underneath that back area of the kitchen. That's good. You know, not wet at all, but it does kind of have like a kind of a damp feel down here. Since there's no window, there's no ventilation, I would probably see if something like that could be maybe taken care of, perhaps, but not too bad. The electric box has all new wiring, and I guess I don't know what the amps are, but I'm not sure even where to look. But we can ask the seller. This is like really very nice here. 200 amp. It's not very good focus. I'm on the second floor, bamboo throughout. I'm in the guest room right now. There's a door that leads out to like a balcony type area. I'm gonna open that up. And you can see there's some outdoor space. Not a huge deck, but certainly plenty for some fresh air. And here it overlooks your yard. Here's your neighbor's yard. There's the neighbor's neighbor's yard. And it looks pretty overgrown to the left. This guest bedroom is approximately, I'm gonna guess now, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 by at least 12. Your hallway is open. That's great. Here, take a look at the bathroom. The bathroom has one of those surround tubs. Those they're kind of cheap, to be honest with you, but they're easy to keep clean, that's for sure. Big vanity, toilet. And your stack washer and dryer, or perhaps side by side. Now it looks like a stack washer and dryer with some room for some shelving. We go into the bathroom here, that's kind of convenient. And you have this little area here that you can put some shelving. That looks kind of cool too. The tiles are big, oversized. I'd say 14 by 14, maybe even bigger. Tiles, white, very nice. Porcelain or marble. So this bedroom has a small closet and is about 9 by 12 as well. So the bedrooms, there are only two. There's a pocket door in the bathroom. I didn't notice that before, but I remember Barbara saying you like pocket doors. So there's one pocket door in the bathroom, and it's in the hall. It looks like there's only one bath in the whole place. And then we're back to this master bedroom. Master bedroom is big enough for maybe a king-size bed and two small end tables and a television or a piece of furniture in the opposite room. But see, the closet here is quite small for if this is the master. So overall, it's cozy. I'm just giving you a look at the front window. If you notice, see, there's only that one small window in the front, and then you have your front door here. So it's not a super wide property. It's certainly much smaller than Girard Avenue, but everything looks like it's in pretty brand spanking new condition and very contemporary. You would definitely not have to do too much. Basement space, I would not say that basement space is really finishable unless you somehow managed to ventilate it and get some fresh air in there, because it's kind of musty air that's not really moving around too much. All right, guys.